17-hour standoff is over, and the man suspected of killing an animal control officer is now under arrest. That standoff ended just after 5 o'clock this morning when the SWAT team snuck into the garage of Joseph Corey's home on First Street. They shot the 65-year-old suspect with a beanbag round and tackled him. And there you could see Corey in the white shirt was taken into custody. We've also just learned from Galt police that there was some sort of a verbal exchange between the suspect and the victims right before Corey allegedly opened fire. Also, we just got this picture into the newsroom of the victim who died, Sacramento County Animal Control Officer Roy Marcum. And today we're learning more about him and the suspect. KCRA3's Mike Lurie is live in Elk Grove where Marcum lived. Mike.
That's right, Lisa. I want to tell you a little bit about Roy Marcum and what we've learned about him today. We know that he was a great family man who was the father of 2 children and 2 stepchildren whom he loved very much. But there's no doubt that one of his best friends in life was a canine, a pit bull named Petunia. And I want to show you now some live pictures or exclusive pictures that we got just moments ago that KCRA captured of Petunia, Roy Markham's canine companion and patrol partner. She frequently sat in the front seat of his pickup truck when he was on patrol. Now, Petunia is a rescue dog, and she was, in fact, in the car last night for about 14 hours when Roy Marcum was killed. His friends and colleagues remember him as a compassionate man.
He just had a way about him. He was so easygoing and laid back. Anybody could talk to him, and he could talk to anybody. And the unfortunate thing is, if he would have talked to this gentleman, if the gentleman would have not been spooked or whatever spurred him on to take the action that he did, it would have had a completely different outcome.
And I want to show you now some pictures, a slideshow, if you will, of Roy Marcum and his family. They lived here in Elk Grove. He was very involved in the lives of his 2 children, Jackie and Roy Jr., and also in the lives of his stepchildren. Now, we talked to the family, and they say right now, of course, they're going through the grieving process, but they're also in the process of setting up a family trust because he wanted to make sure that his kids were well provided for and also had a college fund as well. So they're in the process of doing that today. The other thing that we're hearing both from the family and from his colleagues and friends is that they are advocating very strongly to have bulletproof vests for the animal control officers, something that they say in Sacramento County they don't have. They really believe that had he been able to wear one of those last night, there might have been a very different outcome. Reporting live in Elk Grove, Mike Lurie, KCRA 3 reports.
Mike, thank you very much for your report and that information about Roy. We're also learning a lot more about the suspect, Joseph Corey. KCRA 3 has learned he has a history of financial troubles. According to federal records, the home where he allegedly barricaded himself until this morning was part of a Chapter 7 bankruptcy filing back in April. Citibank held the mortgage on his home and is currently listed as the owner of the property. In September, Corey's bankruptcy case was closed, and according to Sacramento County records, Corey also had some sort of a contract dispute back in 2004. His wages were garnished in order to pay back a little more than $10,000.